Hey guys, Footy Manager TV here. Welcome to episode number 39 of my Lazio Football Manager 2016 Let's Play. So the first game of this episode is at home in the league against Torino, who's currently fifth in the league. They've got some games in hand as well, with a few teams ahead of them, like Milan play 23, Juventus play 22. They also drew their last game, so good opportunity again if we win, go back to 7 points clear this time in the season in February. What, well, 22 games played. I think we'll be in a very good position, and also first Europa League game of the season now in the knockout stage against Sparta Prague, the away leg. So that's going to be very, very important. And I'll talk about my strategy, I suppose you can say, with the last episode, you know, the story with Griezmann, how he can't be registered, but we'll definitely not talk about that anymore. So we're going to just bring on Nguera, like another centre-back to the bench as well. The other two guys are like, really bad morale, so at this time in the season, I'm almost going to act as they're not part of the team. Just like, don't worry about them anymore, because, yeah, next season I'm not going to be playing anyway. So, yeah, like, who cares about them anymore? We don't really need them. But anyway, we're going to be playing Sebastian Drussi. Griezmann is 92% condition. Maybe he could come on and do something. But yeah, Drussi needs some game time because he's going to be eligible to play in the Europa League as well. So yeah, need to get him match fit for that reason. But yeah, in these games where the next game is going to be in the Europa League, we'll rest Philippe Anderson, so he is raring to go for those games. That's going to be my strategy. Generally, we'll be playing Griezmann in this situation though. But he played the previous game. I just got to manage that well. He's had a really good season, Anderson. So I'd really hope he could, yeah, continue that into the Europa League. So I'm not going to complain about it. I'm almost going to use it as a positive. Griezmann can be fit and firing for league games, majority of league games anyway, and make sure we get the result in that. Because winning the league is, what would seem better, winning the Serie A or winning the Europa League? I think it'll be very, very close. Because obviously Europa League's not Champions League, and then winning the league obviously is a big achievement to beat out Juventus in Italy. So yeah, something to think about as we head into the match now. So guys, we're going to have to be careful because they do have Victor Ababo and Jackson Martinez as their strikers. Very dangerous. And Case, oh, from the free kick. What a strike. Wow. That's a goal and a half. Just, I want to go check their stats as well. Oh no, it's Joseph Martinez. I thought the J Martinez. Either way, Joseph Martinez, he's still pretty decent. Well, he's not that good actually. He's pretty average. But for them, obviously, he's a crucial player. So Victor Ababo still, yeah, a key player to watch out for. I was thinking, yeah, I don't think Jackson Martinez would have moved to Torino even in the game. But anyway, there we go. They score the opening goal. That's still, what? How about that 98% possession? I know it's like only first minute, but you don't, yeah, see it that extreme. But anyway, wow, what a goal. How about that? Oh, we're going to have to score a few goals to win this game. And wow, what a free kick from Case. That's a really good free kick. Really solid. Good goal. So I'm not really going to waste time here. We'll just go attacking and chase after that goal. Also, instructions. We'll take off, be more disciplined. And we'll go higher defensive line. Let's go for it, boys. We need that goal quickly. Get it back. So this has really been a pretty disappointing first half, I'll have to say. Sebastian Drussi has picked up a knock. I think that should just allow the entrance of Griezmann at halftime, I would have to say. We need to bring him on, our world-class player, to change up this game because it's going nowhere right now. Sorry, Drussi, but we're going to substitute you for Griezmann. Even if he didn't, I was even considering it leading up to halftime before he picked up the knock. Yeah, we need to make a change. So we're going to say aggressively, though, come on, lad, show a bit of desire. You don't look like a team that wants to win. We're not seeing anything. So hopefully, yeah, that'll be the case. Can we say something extra to Griezmann? I want to see more of the same from you today, and not I want to, we almost need to. So yeah, just deep in thought, do we make any changes attacking wise? Can we be more expressive? We're already like, we are playing more direct, like going shorter passing retain possession, lower tempo, we'll be slowing things down, and I'm not sure if that will be what we exactly want. We need to be, yeah, creating opportunities. Okay, Rugani, Lulic, Griezmann, already getting involved. Lulic, Belotti, what are you doing, mate? That should be 1-1 right now. That should have been equalised, and he's having a crap game. Might as well get substituted. He's not going to score in this game. Ugh, come on. Okay, we have to score from this opportunity. We got to win it back and create a counter. Okay, Rulli, where is he going to go now? To Rugani, Bilia through the middle, Sigurdsson, step up mate as well, Sivkovic, going back to Griezmann. He passes off to Lulic. We got to get it back to him, because then our crap players, and they are crap when you compare them to Griezmann. They just give it away, and they're going to get a goal now. Well fucking done, cunt. Well done. And that Josef Martínez, he scores his second goal of the season. There you go, mate. Exactly. Ebarbo in all the space in the world. But that's because we gave the ball away when we were trying to attack. We were pushing forward, obviously. And you give the ball away like that, of course. That's fucking stupid. I swear, man. This is... I don't even know. I don't even know what to do right now. Can we go three strikers? Can Sigurdsson play striker as well? Can we put Griezmann there? Sigurdsson there? We are going something completely different. But that's what you need to do in a game when it's not going your way at all. Let's go Poacher for Griezmann. I think that's his best role. Or Trequartis. I'm not really sure. How about complete forward? Let's just go complete forward. It's about the same rating anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Sigurdsson, false nine? Interesting. Maybe we'll put... I'll just leave it like that. And then the Zivkovic there. What am I even doing? Yeah, what's the options? I can't even do shit here. Lulic, come off. He gave away that ball. Let's bring on Radu. So... we can't actually do what I wanted there. So we're actually just going to put Griezmann back. This is not good at all if we lose here. We got to just fight to get the draw back. Attack. And Zivkovic. Attack. We're going to have to go overload now. We'll go overload. And we'll go route one. Take more risks. The mixed crosses, let's just whip some crosses in. We have to change that. We just have to change things up in this situation. So we'll play with the two strikers. Belotti will have that. And yeah, Sigurdsson, probably the false nine is the best option for him if you look at the ratings there. So that's what we're going to roll with. And then, is there another change I can make? They're actually... I wouldn't go back to three strikers. I thought, yeah, another substitute we have. Bilia. We got to keep him for the next game as well, so it may be good. Can Stefano Mauri, he can come on as a central midfielder, and then we'll play him advanced playmaker. So, yeah, going fairly attacking. Pretty much have to go for it in team shape. Haven't changed this up for the whole series, I think, in this save. To be honest, just kept on highly structured because it was working. Let's try and go fluid, try and change it up. Come on, boys. But there's a good chance this will probably be a loss because we're changing things drastically. And, yeah. And also, someone said, like, when I make changes like this, people say create a new tactic because it goes down to competent. But it's very rare that I go to this, probably a handful of times in a season. Okay, guys, we have a chance here. 72nd minute. This has to be a goal, but we're just giving the ball away again. The players are just not switched on. Pedali. Okay, now, just create something. Don't give the ball away. This could be it. Zivkovic. Man, pass it. Oh, now we're going to get a yellow card. So, obviously, we were never destined to win this game. Nah, there's no point. There's no point. I know we'll go one centre-back here, but... we can't do anything else because the game is screwing us over once more. I'm trying to hope for something here, but yeah, it's not going to come. Patrick, Belotti, he fucking misses again. Even when the game's over and I know we can't win, I thought the pressure might have been off at least and he could have scored. Sigurdsson. Like, if we score now, I'll be even more mad because, yeah, we had earlier opportunities where we could have scored. Maori. Radu. Griezmann. Even he's fucking up. See, look at all these highlights late in the game, man. But, to be honest, this one should be for them. But no. They... Why are we passing crap? Belotti. What is he going to do with it? Maori. We cannot pass normal. We can't string like 4 or 5 passes together. This is horrendous. I won't be surprised if we lose the next game. And there is another goal. Alessandro Guzzi scores his first goal of the season. So this is going to be the end of the game now. A horrendous performance from all our players. I'm not sure if we had a player that played well. We're going to look at the stats, but I'm not really sure what. Onazi did okay. Zivkovic, but he made some crap passes as well. Belotti 6.1. They're just crap. This is not a league-winning performance. Like a title-winning performance. A team who wins a title doesn't have a performance like that in a season. They lose games, surely. But yeah, not playing like that. That doesn't fill me with confidence going into Europa League. So guys, we've got a few players here on our Central Europe scouting update. Bjorn Engels. I managed him for Club Bruges. I remember I did a Club Bruges save a couple of years ago, I think now. But anyway, Antonio Milic. I don't really know. Not really good players, but I shouldn't really be thinking to sign players. So just fuck it. So guys, we're going to move on to the next game now against Sparta Prague in the Europa League. And as you can see, they don't even have all their real players in their team. You can see there's just a few with numbers there. They're all, like this guy, Frimmel, is not real. So we should be beating a team that has majority of their players that are grayed out players. They're not real players in real life. We definitely shouldn't be losing against this team. So this is the lineup. We're going to keep Belotti. He's been firing this season, but then he's had a poor patch now. And I think he had that poor patch earlier in the season as well. But for the most part, he has scored a lot of goals. Hopefully he kicks into gear against a team we should be beating here. We'll get some away goals, so the second leg we don't really have to worry about as much. Dusan Bastat right back. He's on the yellow card, so I have to be careful of that. Same with Lulic. But should be okay because Radu will come back from suspension in the next game. Rugani's missing as well. So, yeah, there's more than just Griezmann that's not playing this game. We should be all fine with Philippe Anderson. He showed he is a pretty good player this season. Anyway, Sigurdsson, in terms of our new signings in January at least, Sigurdsson is going to have to be the player to step up. Scored 3 times in 6 appearances so far, so he looks the goods. Let's get into it. Orban, deal with it this time. He does. Goes back to Rulli. I feel a bit of nerves, almost. It's still tough, obviously, travelling to a different country. These games. Belotti this time finish. This time he does. Nice finish from Belotti. Andrea, 19th goal of the season. He could keep working to 30 goals for this season. Hopefully, yeah, he's over that bad spell, which was just a handful of games anyway. But yeah, back on the score sheets. That early goal, or early-ish anyway. First half goal, take the lead. Exactly what we need. Goalkeeper came up. Was easy after that. So here they have the ball. Can we win it back once more to create an opportunity for ourselves? Just a wasted ball, aimless for the most part. We've got it back. Anderson now. Anderson. Oh, good ball for Belotti. And he smashes in the second goal of the game in this first half. And he scores his 20th of the season. Smashing start to this game. Exactly what we needed. Anderson, really good ball. His shot he had earlier was poor, but that pass was really good to set up Belotti for his second. Just about to head into halftime now, and Sparta, they haven't even had a shot for the whole game. So we're doing what we're expected of. 2 assists for Anderson, 2 goals for Belotti. Both players have stepped up when we need them to. We'll still say don't get complacent, even though I really think... I knew that was going to come. I can't even be bothered with it. Just don't get confused and demotivated. Just play, man. Just play. Okay, goal kick there, straight to our player in Basta. Sigurdsson, can he get involved in this game? Mahrez as well, we've got key players everywhere. Basta, Philippe Anderson should have scored! But Belotti bags his hat-trick only on the 51st minute, killing off this game in the first leg with the three away goals already. How did the goalkeeper save that, though? That's another goal to Belotti, and that goes down as a hat-trick of assists for Anderson, even though it was just a shot at goal that was saved. Oh, Andrea Belotti picks up a late knock. We'll just take him off there, no risk. Take him off as quickly as possible, but he's going to pick up a permanent injury. Oh, man. In a perfect game like that, just to get injured, and it will be maybe a little injury because he's got that orange notification, that's the last thing we would have wanted, I suppose. At least it wasn't a forced-off injury, even though we did take him off to prevent maybe even more injury. That should be... I just hope it's not really, really long. If it's short-term, and yeah, won't affect us too much. We'll just say I'm happy with the performance. Majority of players reacted well, so that is all good. A few players were looking complacent, but for the most part, yeah, pretty happy. We had a decent performance. We weren't amazing, but we're still able to dominate with three goals from Belotti. Hopefully, he will be all right. Phew, it's only 4 to 5 days. Just a facial injury, physio. Yeah, 4 to 5 days. Yep, lead to physio. Nothing to worry about. Oh, that feels so much better now. Maybe it could have been a few weeks. Generally, that's the maximum when it has that orange notification opposed to red. Red forced off can be anything. But yeah, with the orange, it's never really more than 2 or 3 weeks either way. But it's good. It's just a handful of days. So that's it for this episode. Interestingly enough, we lose 3-0 at home in the league, but we win away from home 3-0 in the Europa League. So it's going to put us in a good position, obviously, to advance to the next stage. Either way, the next episode is going to be big. We're going to play away from home against AC Milan. They need a victory as well. They're trying to fight to get into a European place. And then the home leg against Sparta Prague, you would imagine, will win that and advance. So, yeah, good position. I don't know. I shouldn't have really been worried, but, you know, anything can happen in Football Manager as well. Great position to advance to the next stage. And we're still in a decent position. We're still 4 points ahead. I know the lead is going less and less, but we're still over a game lead. Like, you have three points for the win. So even if we drop a game, we lose. And yeah, even if Juventus catch up on that, we'll still have... it will only be a 1 point lead, but I don't really want to lose many games for the rest of the season. That's 100%. But hope you guys enjoyed it. Drop a like if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel for daily uploads of Football Manager content. And I'll see you guys in the very next episode.